Hey guys, Adam Savage here at the Smithsonian Air and Space Museum in Washington, D.C. One of my favorite places in the world. And here is an identical Viking lander to the two we sent to Mars in the late 70s. And the reason I'm highlighting this is because I built one of these, actually. I think somewhere around 1995, 1996, Dell Computer had a magazine ad in which they wanted a Viking lander for this photograph, and Jamie got the job, and he hired me, and Jamie and I, and I think one other person, built a half-scale replica of this. So still pretty large, like 6 feet wide, in 4 days? Like, I've now been here a bunch of times, but the first time I walked in and saw this, I had so much immediate familiarity with the topography of the object because I had spent those 4 days back in the 90s with my head completely inside this build. So there are all these aspects that I look at and like lovingly laugh about because of the experience. So first of all, I came to the film industry through commercials. And in the film industry, when you work on films like Star Wars Episodes 1 and 2 or the Matrix sequels like I did, you get months to work on different parts of those films. When I worked on Space Cowboys, I worked with a team of 5 people for like 4 months to make the space shuttle. But commercial special effects are a completely different beast. So Jamie getting a call about making a Viking lander and having only 4 days to do it, that was a pretty average build time in commercial special effects. So when you're doing stuff like that, you are looking for every efficiency you can. You are taking the picture of the real thing to the hardware store and buying anything that looks even close. I remember specifically that the landing pads were sets of stainless steel bowls that Jamie had bought and modified ever so slightly to look exactly right. I remember really specifically trying to build a vacuform buck to make the 2 hard shells that cover the spherical fuel tanks on either side. And then I spent a whole day just sewing and getting right the angle of cloth as it wrapped around those gas tank spheres on either side. If I remember correctly, I think there's an alien in the shot, and if I remember correctly, that alien was sculpted by my friend Howie Weed, but I can't say that for sure. Howie famously played the Wampa in the Star Wars Special Edition, and was a model maker and a contributor to ILM's incredible output for many, many years. There's a way in which building stuff, replicating stuff specifically, has always made me feel a sense of connection to the makers of the original objects that I was replicating. I recognize, even though I built this fake 4-day bullshit commercial Viking lander, I still wrapped my head around the topography enough to understand some parts of it in ways that only the original makers do. I'm not saying that I have some sort of like special vision. I'm just saying that crawling over all of the details of something gives you a special insight into that thing. And that is a pleasure that I just keep on chasing in my life. I just thought you'd like to know about that.